my tiptoes are spaced the size of a dinner plate with only dental floss to keep me from plunging to my death? What's my life compared to your happiness? Now, you know, it's true, when we were thinking about the show, we were making it up, and I was thinking about 24/7, what can I do, you know, what's going to make them thrilled and delighted, and, you know, how can I undo myself, and then, no, because I've been at, like, transvestite pinata, I've ridden an elephant, I pissed off half of the young singers in the universe by saying, follow this, you bitches. Just want you to come out, sing in fabulous costumes, and be fabulous. This is my pose for fabulous. That's just what happened, I don't know. Well, anyway, I'm qualified for that job. So hold on a second, I have to get a sip of Dr. Pepper. No, don't give them any kind of zipper. They don't deserve anything. Actually, I'm giving it up. I've been drinking it for far too long. You know, you can say I've given Dr. Pepper the best years of my life. And they have given me, in all the time I've been talking about them, one measly six-pack of Dr. Pepper. Really, guys? I'm just saying, okay? The other night, oh, this is dumb. The other night I played Dallas and I got, you know, Dr. Pepper, the measly six-pack, the sequel. I was standing there, you know, and I was doing my thing, and I happened to look up. And I never actually look up, but those are the box seats up there, right? Is that the box seats? You call them sky seats or box seats or something like that? Is that true? You seem smart, just say yes. Okay. I don't know why they want to be up there. You cannot see shit from up there. The party's down here. Yeah, get your ass down there with the rest of us. Anyway, so I never do look up, but I was looking up and I see this huge banner that says, Dr. Pepper. And I've been trashing them for like 20 minutes. I'm thinking, I'm in trouble now. And I thought, hell with them, they deserve it, I don't care. So I did my show, and I was. And then, let's see, what happened then? But then as I was leaving the stage, and this is the truth, I swear to God. I'm leaving the stage, I'm on my way to the bus, one of my crew guy comes running after me and says, Cher, here, somebody left you this. Somebody left me this sad ass cooler, okay? And it says, to Cher from Dr. Pepper, we love you. She got this bright idea to start putting Perrier in it so I wouldn't get, you know, fat or whatever. And it's too much sugar anyway. So she starts putting the Perrier in it and it kind of tastes like a white wine spritzer. And, alright, well, it tastes more like a white trash white wine spritzer, but still, it's really good. Alright, it's good. It's not bad at all. It fits me fine. Alright, I want to hurry because I'm so excited for you to see how fabulous the show is, and also, but the truth is, I want to hurry because I'm far too old for this show, so I don't get to it. No, I don't know why someone didn't grab me by the shoulders and say, bitch, you're too old. dead. Lots of you would be dead. Maybe five or six people at the most would be alive, but we'd be pretty young. So, all right. And this is, I swear to God, this is truthfully my farewell tour. I'm not kidding. No. I'm not kidding. No doubt about it. It's not a joke. You can verify it with the AARP. I'm not coming back. Okay? This is the absolute truth. This is my farewell sponsor. Okay? Because it is my farewell. Honest to goodness, I'm not kidding. I'm never coming back. I swear to God, tour.